Hello everyone. Today in today's video, in today's lecture class, we are going to deal with energy economics. So yesterday in the previous video, we have dealt with electrical energy conservation. Okay. So we have also seen what are the different 10 ways by which you can save this electrical energy. So in today's class, in the previous coming classes, 2 to 3 classes, we will be completing this energy economics, which is there in the module 1. So what actually is energy economics? So whenever we talk about energy, as you have seen, we should also look into the particular financial analysis part also. Yeah. So how do you perform the financial analysis? That is what we are going to study in the coming lecture. So that is about what I am trying to say is about the energy economics. So whenever you are planning for, or whenever you are thinking about this particular energy efficiency concept or energy management project, so the first things or many things that comes to your mind is what are the different what you can say, the costs that are involved, that should always be considered. So whenever you are planning for energy efficiency or energy management project, remember, or any project whenever you are doing which is related to energy management, so what are the costs that are involved in it, that actually should be considered. So this particular energy economics is going to play a very important vital role in any of the energy management projects. So therefore, as with any other type of investment, so energy management proposals, they should show the likely return on any of the capital that is invested. So you see, in a, suppose whenever you are going to start a business, why do you start a business? So to get a kind of return on investment, whatever you are investing, the money that you are investing, clear, you should get some kind of return. So nobody is going to start a business in order to for a loss. Okay, so everybody, they actually wanted some kind of return on, in the form of money. Most probably in the form of money, they need in the kind of return on any of the capital that they have invested on a particular project. And we are talking about here the energy management project. So consider, suppose you consider the case of an energy auditor, which we already studied about this, what actually happens in this auditing section done by energy auditor. So if you consider the case of energy auditor, actually, the energy auditor is that particular person who advises the senior management of an organization, clear, that capital should be invested in a particular area. Clear? For example, you take that there is an energy auditor who has advised a particular senior manager or senior management level person that you try to invest in a particular boiler plant, a new boiler plant, it should be installed. So inevitably, the next question which will be posed by the management of that particular organization organization would ask is, how much will be the proposed cost? So to whom the management of that particular organization is going to ask? He is going to ask the energy auditor, who has given the proposal that this should be the project which we are going to carry out in the next, maybe the next project will be this. For example, the next project will be investing money on a new boiler plant. So inevitably, what happens is the management of the organization is going to ask, how much will be the proposed cost? Here, how much will be the proposed cost? Then how much money will be saved by the proposal? So here, these two questions the management is going to cost, that what will be the proposed cost. Proposed cost means it is not the actual cost. What is the estimation cost? And by this proposal, if I do this particular project, how much money I am going to save in terms of energy management, energy management that we are talking about. So these are, of course, not unreasonable questions. Don't think that these are unreasonable questions, because within any organization, there are many what we call it, each of which requires funding, and it is the job of senior management to invest in capital where it is going to obtain the greatest return. So every work requires funding, every work requires money, investment. So being in the position of that particular senior management level, he should know that he is going to get some kind of at least minimum return for the investment whatever he is doing on a particular energy management project. So in order to take make a decision whether to start or whether to investment on a particular project, so in any course of action, so these the management they need to, needs to be able to appraise all the costs. The management, they should know that what are all the costs that are involved in a particular project, and determine, at least estimate, what will be the potential returns on the investment in future. So this, however, is not quite as simple as it appears. Yeah. So the capital value of the plant or the equipment is usually decreasing with time, that we are talking about a depreciation. So suppose you have invested suppose 5 lakhs on a particular car. This is for example. Yeah. Similarly, you're investing for the plant, or you're investing on the industry, or investing on the particular equipment. Okay, we are talking about tangible products here. You're investing on that. So that particular the capital value is going on decreasing. See, when you buy a car for 5 lakhs, after 1 year, what will happen is the capital value that you have invested, that is 5 lakhs, if you want to sell after 1 year, that particular 5 lakhs, that price is not going to come when you are selling that particular car. Okay. Similarly, for a particular plant, the capital value and the equipment, the capital value of the equipment also decreases with time. What happens is these equipment, they require more maintenance as it goes older. Yeah, maintenance cost will become more and more if the equipment is becoming older. So if you are borrowing the money from the bank to particular finance on a particular project, then one more thing will also come into picture, is that is interest. So you have to pay interest on the loan also. Clear? Similarly, one more point is inflation also will influence the value of any future energy savings that might be achieved. Clear? So here what I am trying to say is, suppose whenever you are borrowing a particular money from a bank, you are going to pay the interest, which is also again interest that you have to pay on the loan. And similarly, this particular inflation also is going to have a particular influence. So what is actually inflation? Inflation, actually, it refers to rise in prices for most of the goods or services of daily or common use, so such as food, clothing. Now, inflation means, you can say, not only about this food, clothing, housing, recreation, you can say it is a measurement of average price change. So every day what will happen is the price is changing, so the value of any future energy savings might change. So it is therefore important that the cost appraisal process allows for all these factors. So with this aim of determining which investments should be undertaken or optimizing the benefits achieved, to this end a number of accounting and financial appraisal techniques has to be developed. They have been developed. So by virtue of which these financial appraisals and accounting techniques, they are going to help these energy managers and energy auditors to make correct decisions, to make an objective oriented decision. So these financial issues, which whatever that has been associated with the capital investment in this energy sector or energy saving projects, that we are going to investigate. So mainly we are going to read about some techniques like the discounted cash flow techniques of NPV method, that is net present value, net present value method. Then we are also going to study about internal rate of return. These are discussed in detail. You can see internal rate of return, net present value, these all these things, discount rate, payback period, life cycle cost, net present value. These things we are going to study in detail, and we are going to solve some examples or some numericals also based on these. Clear? So which you'll find much more interesting. So before going into this particular accounting and financial appraisal techniques in detail, if you before going into that, so let us learn about some parameters which will be coming across in your whenever you are going through this particular project or energy economics, this particular method, the initial rate of return or present value or net present value NPV method. So you should know, and basically in a particular economic subject you might have studied all these things also, but still you might have some idea about this, but still let us see. So fixed and variable cost. What is actually fixed cost and variable cost? Okay, so whenever you are appraising the potential cost that is going to be involved in a particular energy project, it's very important for you to understand what is the difference between this particular fixed cost and variable cost. Okay, fixed cost and variable cost, you should know some particular difference. Okay, so what is actually fixed cost? Fixed cost and variable cost, let us study. Now in this particular economics, mainly when we talk about general economics, when we talk about these are the two main important type of costs that a particular company or an industry incurs. Okay, now in a simple way, let me talk about let me try to make you understand in a simple way. So whenever you are producing goods or services, goods means tangible, services are intangible. Tangible means you can see, you can feel. Intangible means these are coming under services which you cannot see. So variable cost is going to vary depending upon how much amount of the output that you are producing. Remember, variable cost varies depending upon the amount of output that you are producing in a particular company, and fixed cost remains the same no matter how much the company produces. This simple thing you try to remember. Variable cost is going to variable, the name itself, variable cost is going to vary with the amount of output that the company produces, and fixed cost will remain the same no matter how much is the company is going to produce. Clear? So this is what variable cost is totally way it is, as I told you. What is variable cost? Will include this labor commission, labor cost, raw material cost. Clear? So as I told you, fixed cost, irrespective of whatever is the production output, it is not going to change. It remains the same. That is rent or lease. Clear? Insurance, interest payment, suppose you are buying a land, all these are fixed costs. Clear? Now, as said, these variable costs are those which are directly which are going to vary directly with the output of the particular plant or production process, such as fuel cost. As we are talking about energy management, then energy economics as we are talking about. So next is, in case of fixed cost, these are those costs which are not dependent on plant or process output. Clear? What is the output? It is irrespective. Whether the output is 100 products per day or 1 lakh number of products per day, that's, the fixed cost remains the same. So it can be the site rent or the insurance or the lease that you're for paying for 5 years or maybe for 99 years. So the total cost of any project is the summation of fixed cost and summation of fixed cost and variable cost. So let us try to see a particular small problem, clear? So by virtue of which you can easily understand actually how both fixed cost and variable cost are going to combine to make the total operating cost. So let us see a small problem. Okay, so this particular example let us study in the next class, clear? By which you'll try to have you'll get a brief idea about this fixed cost and variable cost. Okay, I hope you have understood this, and let us meet in the next class. We'll continue this. Thank you.